Hello people, in this video, let us look at what enucleation is. Okay, enucleation. It's one word, enucleation. Basically, it is nothing but a removal of the eyeball. Okay, so basically it's an operation where they will remove the eyeball. It is complete excision of the eyeball. This entire thing with this white part that is sclera, everything is removed. Okay, so first of all, you need to understand what the difference between eye and eyeball is. So now, like what you're seeing here is the eye, correct? So basically, eye has what and all, it has some muscles, right? Lot of muscles which hold this eyeball. But here we are removing only the eyeball, we are not removing the muscles. Okay. So basically, what is enucleation? It is the removal of this eyeball, okay? The sclera, everything, this white part, everything. So basically, what are the indications for enucleation? Why would somebody do it? Basically, the absolute indications are like retinoblastoma, which is a malignant condition. Right, and the malignant melanoma, which is of the melanocytes, it's also cancer. So these two are cancerous conditions. They will remove enucleation. This is not as simple as all retinoblastomas. There are some grades in this, grade E or something. Wait, we look at that. So basically, whenever there is a group E, so treatment of choice for group E tumor, when the tumor involves more than half of the retina, when the optic nerve is involved, right? So these are the specifications of that indication for retinoblastoma. When glaucoma is present, anterior chamber gets involved, and all this. So these are the conditions which will decide, okay? So basically, one thing with enucleation for retinoblastoma is that whenever the eyeball is being excised, the longest possible portion of the optic nerve also should be excised, okay? So basically, so during enucleation for retinoblastoma, the longest possible piece of optic nerve also should be excised, okay? So you should remove the optic nerve in such a way that you should not perforate the eyeball, okay? Eyeball should be enucleated along with maximum length of the optic nerve, taking special care not to perforate the eyeball, okay? Then, so this is one of the things for enucleation. Are you understanding, guys? What are we discussing? We are discussing removing of the eyeball, that is enucleation. So basically, we saw the absolute indications are like retinoblastoma and malignant melanoma. So basically, retinoblastoma, you saw, we will have to remove it with the longest possible portion of the optic nerve. Now, malignant melanoma affects what? The melanocytes. So this is performed, this enucleation, that is removal of eyeball, is performed when the iris melanoma is associated with secondary glaucoma. They seem to be linking all with glaucoma. Glaucoma plus the tumor, glaucoma plus the tumor. Because in retinoblastoma also, if you remember, they said the glaucoma plus the tumor, isn't it? Let's see this, wait. In retinoblastoma also, they said glaucoma is present, yeah. So they seem to be linking both of them, okay. Now let us go to the relative indication. So did you understand the absolute indications? Say the two absolute indications, retinoblastoma, malignant melanoma, okay. Then coming to the relative indications are painful blind eye. See, both the terms are important here. Painful blind eye. That means if a person has blind eye, no need to remove his eyeball. Okay. But only if it is a useless eye, if it's a blind eye and it is painful, then they will remove it. Should you remove a painful eye? No. Painful eye might still be able to see. So both these conditions should be there. Painful blind eye. Okay. So again, they are always talking about glaucoma associated with intraocular tumors. Same thing seems to be getting repeated, isn't it? Then mutilating ocular injury. So if this ocular injury, right, if there is ocular injury, what will happen? There is something called as sympathetic ophthalmitis. So if this is one eye and there is another eye here, right, and this guy eye gets injured, okay, some trauma and this eye gets injured. But what happens? This eye also starts showing symptoms and it starts, the condition starts deteriorating in the healthy eye. So this is called as sympathetic ophthalmitis, and so what they do, they enucleate this injured eye, okay. So let's check this, okay, hold on. So as a treatment for sympathetic ophthalmitis, okay, so what they are doing is the injured eye, which has no useful vision, if it does not have any useful vision, the injured eye, which is the useless eye, should be excised at once for a treatment for, this is a treatment for sympathetic ophthalmitis, to save the other eye, okay. Then coming to the next thing here, thesis bulbi. Thesis bulbi, bulbi, however you want, you can say. So three things we have looked at so far, right? We looked at painful blind eye. Then we looked at mutilating ocular injury and thesis bulbi. Now, thesis bulbi is nothing but a shrunken non-functional eye. A shrunken, put your fingers together and say shrunken, thesis bulbi, non-functional eye. Okay, again, there is no function here. So, this may need to be removed. Okay, then anterior staphyloma. Anterior staphyloma, basically staphyloma is the abnormal protrusion of the uveal tissue through a weak point in the eyeball. So, there's a protrusion from out of the eyeball. What is protruding? The uveal tissue. Okay. So, if there is an anterior staphyloma, it's a relative indication for enucleation. Okay. So, we have looked at the relative indications. So, what are the indications? Two tumors you saw as absolute, then you saw four relative indications for enucleation of eyeball. Okay. How is it going, guys? So, shall we continue? Good. So, there is yet another indication for enucleation of eyeball. So, basically, this is in cadaver, that is in dead body, right? In the dead. So, how in the cadaver they will remove the eye, basically for cornea transplant, keratoplasty, right? So, this is the most common indication for enucleation. Look at this, which is the most common indication for enucleation, obviously from a dead body, from the cadaver, they will remove the eyeball, right? Who and all can do this? An ophthalmic surgeon or even a medical officer who's trained in enucleation, he can do this cadaveric enucleation, okay? And an eye band technician will assist this procedure. So, enucleation in cadaver, you saw who will do it? Ophthalmic surgeon, medical officer who's trained in this, and a technician can assist. Okay. So, now let us move on, guys, to the steps. Okay, before that, tumors of ciliary body also, they can do enucleation. Basically, if there are very large tumors with some specific dimension, then tumors of ciliary body also, they can do enucleation. Okay. So, let's move on now. So, basically, enucleation, we'll have to look at the procedure, right, guys? So, let's look at the procedure now. So, basically, this enucleation is done under local anesthesia for adults. So, just a local anesthesia is enough for you guys. But if it is a child, they will give general anesthesia. Is this clear? For an adult, just local anesthesia is sufficient. That's what you're saying here. So, basically, what are the steps? So, you can see here, they are doing some things here. This is step A. Let us look at what this is. Okay. So, first of all, look at the steps. Okay. Separation of conjunctiva and tenons capsule. So, they are separating the conjunctiva and tenons capsule here. Let's look at the steps details. Then they will separate the extraocular muscles. They will cut the optic nerve. They'll remove the eyeball. They will insert the orbital implant and they'll close the conjunctiva and tenons capsule and fit artificial prosthetic eye. To explain in very simple words, okay. So, basically what is happening, where is our eye? Yeah, look at this. So, basically, this is the eye, isn't it? In the eye, you have the muscles which are holding the eyeball. Now, they want to remove the eyeball. So, what they will do, first of all, whatever is there on top, that mucus kind of membrane, conjunctiva, right, they will remove that conjunctiva, they will separate it out, right, then these muscles are cut, okay, obviously they have to cut the muscles, then they will detach this eyeball from the optic nerve, they will cut behind, they will detach it from the optic nerve, now the eyeball is pulled out, it comes out, then they are going to put an orbital implant here, so basically to cover this hole, they will put an orbital implant, this is an orbital implant, you can see here. So, they will put this orbital implant and they will, the muscles will start holding this dummy ball, okay. And then, after some days, they will give a prosthetic eye. So, just for cosmetic purposes, they will give this kind of a prosthetic eye. The person cannot still see from this eye, okay. It just looks beautiful. So, look at this first step now. Separation of conjunctiva and tenons capsule. So, here, conjunctiva is incised all around the limbus with the help of a spring scissors. So, they are going to use a spring scissors and they are going to incise the conjunctiva all around the limbus. So, that is what they are showing here, you can see. So, they are using the spring scissors, you can see the scissors. Whatever you are seeing here, these are the lid retractors. Here, you are seeing the spring scissors and they are cutting the conjunctiva, right, around the limbus. So, conjunctiva is incised all around the limbus with the help of spring scissors. undermining of the conjunctiva and tenons capsule is done combinedly all around up to the equator using blunt tipped curved scissors. This maneuver exposes the extraocular muscles. Okay. So basically here they are showing you the tenon capsule, and where will the conjunctiva be which we are concerned? They are removing the conjunctiva. They are cutting it here around the limbus. So basically all this conjunctiva which is there on this eye, on the sclera, that is the bulbar conjunctiva, all that they are separating, right? To expose the what? To expose the extraocular muscles. So you can see here, you want to look at the muscles. What are the muscles you want? Extraocular muscles, that will be like the lateral rectus. Then what else you can see here? Inferior rectus. You can see even the inferior oblique muscles, superior rectus also here they are shown. So basically they want to get to these muscles. Let's go to the next step. They want to separate the ocular muscles, extraocular muscles. They want to separate the extraocular muscles. Hold on. They want to separate the extraocular muscles. Let's go to this one now. Separation of extraocular muscles. Okay, guys. Let's move on. So this is the next step. They want to separate the extraocular muscles. This one. So here, the rectus muscles are pulled out one by one with the help of a muscle hook, and a 3-0 silk suture is passed near the insertion of each muscle. The muscle is then cut. The muscle is cut with the help of tenotomy scissors, leaving behind a small stump carrying the suture. So what are they using here? Some tenotomy scissors. They will use this tenotomy scissors and cut the muscle and leave behind a small stump, okay, which carries the suture. So something you can see here, the suture, right? The inferior and the superior oblique muscles are hooked out and cut near the globe. So for the superior and inferior oblique muscles, some different procedure, they are hooked out and cut near the globe. Okay, so basically all the muscles which are holding the eyeball have been cut. Okay, now let us go to the next step here. The next step is what? Cutting of optic nerve. So they want to get behind this eyeball and they want to cut the optic nerve. So they are going behind the eyeball. You can see this, the eyeball is prolapsed out by stretching and pushing down the eye speculum. So they are going to prolapse it out, the eyeball. So the eyeball, they're trying to pull it out. The eyeball is pulled out with the help of sutures passed through the muscle stump. So using these sutures, they're pulling it out, right? And the enucleation scissors is then introduced along the medial wall up to the posterior aspect of the eyeball. So what is going in here? It is the enucleation scissors, right? And then what does this do? You're going to cut the optic nerve, right? The optic nerve is felt and then cut with the scissors while maintaining a constant pull on the eyeball. So they are pulling here and cutting the optic nerve behind. Muscles which we are holding have already been cut. So optic nerve is cut. Now the eyeball comes out. The eyeball is pulled out of the orbit by incising the remaining tissue adherent to it. So any remaining tissue they will adhere into it. They will remove. They will pull the eyeball out. Guys, we have come out. The eyeball has come out now. Okay. Now what will they do to achieve hemostasis, that is for concerning the blood, right? To achieve hemostasis, what they will do, they will pack the orbital cavity, right? They will use wet pack, they will pack the orbital cavity and press it back to achieve what? Hemostasis, okay? Then what they will do, now they have achieved hemostasis, okay? Now they will put this orbital implant. Where is that implant guy? Where did he go? So this is the implant. The correct size, whichever you think is right, that size you should insert into the orbit and sutured with the rectus muscle. It is sutured with the muscles which we cut. Interesting. Okay. So guys, where are we? After the extraocular muscles were separated, they cut the optic nerve, then they removed the eyeball. They have now inserted the orbital implant, right? Orbital implant is what? PMMA medpar or hydroxyapatite. Apatite, not appetite. It's apatite. Okay. So we are done with this step. Let's move on to the next step. Okay. So what is the next step? closure of conjunctiva and Tenon's capsule. So the Tenon's capsule and the conjunctiva that you had in the initial cut and to expose the muscles, now you'll bring them back, right? So closure of conjunctiva and Tenon's capsule. So basically, to know about this, look at this. So here, the Tenon's capsule, right, and conjunctiva shown here. So basically, what they are saying is the Tenon capsule is sutured horizontally with 6-0 vicryl or chromic catgut. Okay, conjunctiva is sutured vertically so that conjunctival fornices are retained deep with 6-0 silk sutures. I hope I'm saying it right. 6-0, 6-0. Okay. So this is silk suture for conjunctiva. For Tenon's capsule, they are saying vicryl or chromic catgut. Okay. Then, the silk sutures which are removed after 8 to 10 days, they are saying. Okay. So they will remove these sutures on the conjunctiva. After completion of surgery, antibiotic ointment is applied, lids are closed, dressing is done with firm pressure using sterile eye pads and bandage. So the surgery is done now. Okay. So after a few days, what they will do, they will give this prosthetic eye. Conformer may be used post-operatively so that the conjunctival fornices are retained deep. A proper size prosthetic eye can be inserted for good cosmetic appearance after 6 weeks when healing of the enucleated socket is complete. So when the enucleated socket is healed, then you can put a prosthetic eye. Okay. Let's look at that. So here you go. Before and after pictures. Without artificial eye, with artificial eye. They cannot see anyways, okay? This one. Okay. So now let us go back here. Some more details are there here. So where exactly the scissors was used? Spring scissors. Yes, in the first step itself, right? For the incising the conjunctiva all around the limbus, spring scissors, okay? Then where did we use this one? Enucleation spoon. Enucleation spoon to engage the optic nerve during enucleation. To engage the optic nerve during enucleation. This one actually we didn't see in the explanation. Now this one, enucleation scissors. This one was mentioned. You go behind and you feel the optic nerve and cut it, right? So these are used to cut the optic nerve during enucleation operation. This is the enucleation scissors. So specific tools are there with the name enucleation. That is the enucleation spoon, enucleation scissors. Both of them are used for optic nerve purposes. Okay. After enucleation, what problems can occur? Mechanical entropion because of lack of support. Right, so the infold of the eyelid, right, that is what is entropion and it's mechanical. Then also orbital cellulitis can happen, intraorbital abscess also can happen, okay. So what are these? These are infections, right. They can result because of the surgery. So guys, we have looked at the surgery, enucleation, to the best of our knowledge. There could be mistakes, so please read the textbook and understand. Now, there is one more thing called as evisceration. This is different because they are removing the content of the eyeball, not the eyeball. So, the sclera will be left behind in evisceration. Okay. But however, in enucleation, we are removing the entire eyeball, right? We are not, this entire thing comes out to your hand. Okay. But what they are saying is in evisceration, they will keep this eyeball, only the content, whatever is there, in evisceration, they will remove the content. Okay. But here we are talking about enucleation. Complete removal of the eyeball, okay, with the sclera. So what else do you want to know? Let's take a quick recap of what we have seen in this video. Enucleation, what exactly it is, operation, complete excision of the eyeball with the sclera. Absolute indications are retinoblastoma, that is group E, and malignant melanoma. If it is associated with secondary glaucoma, a lot of conditions will be there. Relative indications are painful blind eye, mutilating ocular injury, thesis bulbi or thesis bulbi, however you want to say, anterior styphiloma, And in the dead, it will be a cadaveric enucleation for iodination. Okay, so explaining each one we have done, even in tumors of ciliary body, if they are very large. Then we saw how it is done with local anesthesia in adults and general anesthesia in children, and obviously no anesthesia in a cadaver. Separation of conjunctiva and tenon's capsule. Right, separation of conjunctiva and tenon capsule. So that is the first thing. Then separation of the extraocular muscles, cutting of the optic nerve, then you will remove the eyeball. You will insert an orbital implant, that is PMMA medpar or hydroxyapatite. See this PMMA medpar, hydroxyapatite. Okay, then closure of the conjunctiva and tenon's capsule. You will fit an artificial prosthetic eye. To the best of whatever we understood, we have told here. Okay, D is insertion of orbital implant, they are saying, and E is closure of the conjunctiva. Where is the orbital implant here? Okay, then what else? We saw the instruments, a lot of instruments, but we are only showing a few here. Enucleation spoon, enucleation scissors, before after pictures. What are the problems after enucleation? Mechanical entropion, orbital cellulitis, intraorbital abscess. Okay, so we saw how it is different from evisceration operation also. So that was it. Enucleation done. Bye bye.